So if we look at the life cycle of a frog, so the frog, it lay the eggs into the water. Now the eggs, they are fertilized by the male cells of other frog and becomes into zygotes. So these zygotes are hatched to release small babies of frog. Here, let us look at these small babies. They are not at all looking like frogs. Just they are looking like small fish. We call them as tadpoles. So they have a fish-like appearance. Not only the appearance, they have gill structures. So here they swim and they breathe with the gills. Actually, frogs do not breathe with gills, but when it is in the stage of tadpoles, they breathe with the gills. So later it develops the limbs, hands and legs. But even then, still it will have a tail, tail frog. So later on, the frog, it loses its tail. The tail will slowly, it disappears. Now the frog, it gets its original shape, resemblance with their mother. So in its life cycle, it is changing its shape, its appearance. And the total process from changing from the zygote to the complete frog, it is called as metamorphosis. Metamorphosis. So these kind of changes are observed. But here the security is very less for the babies of the frog when the development takes place in the outside environment. There are so many threats. The eggs may be eaten by other fish and other animals easily. That is the reason why the frogs, they lay their eggs in large number and they are fertilized in large number. Even though there are so many millions and millions of eggs are fertilized, only a few develop into frogs because remaining will be eaten. In case of mammals, only one egg cell is produced by the female, but the egg cell develops into a baby because the development takes place inside the body of mother. So care is taken, protection is high if you see that internal fertilization and internal development, whereas in the external case, this protection is very less. So this is the life cycle of the frog. Cloning. Cloning is a very interesting process that is observed in reproduction. It is a special way of reproduction done in lab conditions to produce the animals which are identical to the parent. That means if we have selected an animal, say A, if its offsprings or generation, the next generation will have the characteristics of the A and its partner. If this is the male animal, the female animal characters also will come to this baby. But by the process of cloning, we can produce the exact copies of organisms. That means if there is a person with some characteristics, so we can produce some other person with the same characteristics. That means exact characteristics, exact appearance. So that is possible by cloning. Now see, let us see how it is possible. In normal reproduction, there are two gametes, male and female gametes. They will have nucleus. So when they fertilize, both the nuclei will join and a common nucleus is formed in the zygote. So if this zygote is developed into a baby, the baby exhibits characteristics of the mother and father, both male and female, because both the nuclei are clubbed together. This is normal fertilization. But in cloning, to which organism they wanted to clone? For example, they wanted to prepare a clone for a cow. So from this cow, they will take one cell. That cell is not reproductive cell. Any cell from its body, from its skin, from its muscle, any one cell is taken. Right? So that is not a reproductive cell, the cell which it is taken. They wanted to make exact copy of this cow. So the cell will contain the nucleus and at the same time they will select another cow and from that cow they will collect ovum. So ovum is a reproductive cell. It also will have nucleus. So here they have selected one normal cell, not reproductive cell, and they selected the reproductive cells of another animal, that is the ovum of cow B, cow A. So what they do is They remove the nucleus from this ovum. The nucleus is removed. The ovum is left without any nucleus now. So this is all done in lab condition. Only the scientist can do this process with the help of sophisticated equipment. Generally, we cannot see the ovum and we cannot remove the nucleus out of the ovum with our simple techniques. It's a very complicated process. So anyway, this is removed. The nucleus is removed and the ovum is free without any nucleus. Now, whatever the cell is selected from this cow A, from that cell, the nucleus is separated and introduced into this cell. So now it becomes a zygote. So how it became the zygote? It is having the empty ovum without nucleus, and nucleus from a normal cell of that cow is introduced here. Now this zygote is ready for development. It can become into embryo, it can become into fetus to baby. Now this zygote is placed in the body of the cow. Implantation. Implantation takes place. So this zygote is placed in the uterus of that cow B. The cow B is, inside the reproductive system of cow B, this zygote is developing into fetus, into the calf. So the calf is born. Now how the calf looks like, A or B? The calf, it will be the exact replica, copy of cow A. It will not have any characteristics of cow B. Even though it is grown in the uterus of the cow B, it doesn't show any characteristics. It is sharing the womb. It is growing in the womb of cow B. It has taken the ovum, but no characteristics, because the characteristics are decided by nucleus. So there is no share of cow B in this zygote, in the nucleus, because the nucleus is completely belong to cow A. So that is the reason the cow A's copy is the calf. Exact copy. In such a way, exact copies of animals can be produced. It was experimentally proven by a scientist named as Ian Wilmot, who successfully cloned a sheep, and he named the sheep as Dolly. So this Ian Wilmot, he selected two sheep. One is Finn Dorset and Scottish Blackface. Now, as I told you that he collected one cell from the mammary glands of this Finn Dorset. This is a normal cell, not the reproductive cell. And he collected the ovum from this blackface sheep. Blackface, he collected the ovum. Now he removed this nucleus. Nucleus is removed. This nucleus is introduced here. So this ovum will be having the nucleus of Finn Dorset. So this is the zygote which is having nucleus of Finn Dorset. This zygote is kept in the uterus of this Scottish blackface. So the Scottish blackface sheep, that it has taken the pregnancy, and this zygote is completely developed into a baby, and baby is born. Small lamb was born, that is in 1996. This experiment was done and successfully a lamb was born and named as Dolly. So now this Dolly is the exact copy of this Finn Dorset, which is white, white faced. This is a black faced one. None of the characteristics of this Scottish blackface have come to Dolly, even though the Dolly has grown in the womb of blackface. Because the characteristics are decided by the nucleus. So the nucleus of this zygote is completely belongs to the Finn Dorset. So Dolly was born. So in this way, we can produce exact copies of people. So people think that it's a wonderful process. We can produce a number of same kind of film actors, number of film actors, a number of celebrities. We can make number of copies. Of course, it looks like an amazing and interesting process. There are so many problems involved in this. So many scientists claim that cloning is not a healthy process, and the organisms that are born by cloning cannot live for a longer time. So that is what happened with, same happened with the Dolly. The Dolly could produce the young ones of its own kind by sexual means, but it died very early with a lung disease. And later on, so many scientists tried to develop clones of cow and different mammals, but many of these clones, they died during the pregnancy. And even though they were born, they born with birth defects, and many of the clones, they died so early. So So there are claims that cloning is not a healthy process. It is not an advisable process. And the difficulties or disadvantages, problems that involve in the cloning are to be completely studied before the process has to be taken up. So that is about cloning.